Alrighty, well, hello there. Here we are on Friday, July 17th, 2020, at 9:18 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And for about 1 to 2 weeks now, I've been trying to catch sight of that comet Neowise. But so far, it's been no luck. It's been too low in the horizon and down in the trees over there, so... But each night after the sun sets, it's getting higher and higher in the sky. So I'm hoping we'll have a chance to catch it either tonight or tomorrow, while the weather still holds, it is. And at the moment, it's too light outside yet. So we are facing the northwest, and it should be up about 18 to 20 degrees above the horizon, about 317 degrees. In the northwest. Anyway, tonight we're on the Canon 80D with a new Tamron 35-150 lens. It's an f/2.8-4. And I don't have much equipment to use right now. I sent most of the gear into a KEH camera to get an evaluation to sell most of it. There's a lot of the EF-S lenses that I wasn't using, but I did send in even some of the better equipment, like my beautiful Canon EOS R. I miss that baby. But with the release of the new Canon R5 and R6, I sure would like to free up some money and possibly get one of those. We shall see. It'll probably take about 1 to 2 weeks to get the evaluation and the quotes and all that. So we'll see how that goes. But I did have a disaster strike right when I was getting ready to sell this stuff. I dropped my main lens that I use every single day, the Tamron 24-70 G2 lens, f/2.8. Oh man, my heart broke. And that's a big expense too, but oh well. Maybe if I get some decent prices for this gear, I'll be able to have it fixed. Okay, once it gets dark enough out, I'll try to take some pictures and try to capture this elusive comet. I've seen some great captures from people over in Europe. Monique over in Holland, and Oliver Steiger, he's from Switzerland, I believe, and Skywatcher Dinos, he's over in Greece, and Movie Vertigo, he's from the UK, and he's got some great footage of the comet. And here's hoping I get it before it dims and disappears for another 6,800 years, because you know what? I ain't going to be around then. But anyway, I'll be back later. Let me shut this off for now, and bye now. Well, it seems to be another night we're shut out here. Are a whole bunch of bugs and stuff flying around my security light. And a lightning bug. Whoa, some cool ones there. Hey, I spoke too soon. I was able to catch a comet over in some pictures, and it's barely showing up here on video. Oh, I wish I had my other camera. But that faint speck of light there, near the middle, is Comet Neowise, who's on a journey, a 6,800-year journey. So won't be back for a very long time. Now it's not going to come out very well, as we can see. I'll try to get the pictures put together. I'm not seeing too much here on the monitor, except a couple dead pixels, two stars, and a faint blob of a comet. Now just so you know, I can't see it by eye. I can't even see the Big Dipper up there. My skies are just way too light polluted. But anyway, that's cool. I hope you all have a chance to see it. I am really surprised about where it is. It was only supposed to be up about 18 degrees above the horizon. Well, that was earlier. Let me see where it is now. It's 15 degrees up, 322 degrees in the northwest. And I would have thought that would have been in the trees by now, but apparently not, because there it is. All right, cool, let me go in and get the pictures processed and try to put a video together for you. Oh, I'm stoked. This is great. Now, these mosquitoes are having a field day with me, so they can hitch a ride on that comet and bugger off our planet. Anyway, this one's for you, Preston. Have a wonderful journey ahead, buddy. Take care. And I hope you all have a wonderful weekend. Good luck to you and your viewing, and I hope you have a chance to see it. All right, y'all take care now. It's 10:14 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. Goodbye, Comet. All right, take care now. Bye.